Hi there, and welcome to this month's edition of For the Love of Animals. Welcome back and Happy New Year. We took the month of January off to recuperate from all of the holiday festivities. I wanted to take a moment before we started our show and thank everybody for all of the support we received in 2016, whether it was through an adoption or a financial donation, whether it was stopping in during our adoption time to give us the many kind words that we have received over the year. Thank you. We really appreciate it. You have no idea how much it helps to hear your kind words and especially receive your donations. As you know, they are very needed. So thank you so much for all your support. We certainly could not do it without you. I also wanted to mention that we have launched our new website this year, 2017. We just released it in January. So if you haven't seen it, jump on and check it out at www.hhas.org and see what you think. It's a work in progress right now. We're still learning how to use it, but I'm sure as the months go by, we will be able to learn it to the best. All right, I wanted to say congratulations. We did have one adoption last month, and that was Austin. I don't know if you remember seeing him prior to the holidays. He was hoping to get into his home before the holidays, and he did. So congratulations, Austin. We are so happy that you made it home for the holidays. Congratulations. Okay, without further ado, let's bring out our first adoptable pet. Okay, this is Addie, and Addie is a beautiful black lab mix. And the reason I say mix is she's definitely a lot smaller than your average Labrador. And she's pretty much full grown, we believe, in size. She's just about a year. So the veterinarian believes she's full grown, maybe about 35 pounds. So she's a great, I think, size, medium sized dog. But she is full of energy. She is at that peak of youth where I believe they have a lot of energy. And not to say that at any of the ages between now and 3 years old, they still don't have a lot of energy, because I believe between 1 and 3 years old, you see a lot of energy out of some breeds of dogs, and Labradors being one of those breeds. But she definitely is a high energy pup. So therefore, she does require a fenced in yard. She does do great with other dogs, the dogs, I should say, that we've seen her with. Remember, we can't just always assume because the dogs, or a majority of dogs we've seen her with, she does do well with, that she's going to do great with all dogs. So if she does look like a dog that you would be interested in, we would set up a meeting with your dog, and whether that be in the front of your home or, you know, at a neutral park, what have you, we'll make those arrangements. But the first step would be for you to come to our adoption center, which, honey, come here, stay here, which is PetSmart in Bolingbrook, and you can visit there with our adoption counselors and greeters and Addie. But always make sure you call ahead, because the dogs don't always visit every adoption time. They don't actually take turns. It's upon availability of our handlers who can bring the dogs in. So call ahead to make sure. Addie will be there if you'd like to come and meet her. But she is a wonderful little girl. She will need obedience training because of that high energy. She does need to learn her commands. But when she does, she is going to be a wonderful addition to someone's family. I guarantee it. I promise. And the dogs that she has played with, she does really great with. She seems to respect different play styles. She can play really rough, and we've seen her respect some older dogs, and, you know, when enough is enough, she respects them and she stops. So that's really nice to know that she can respect an elder dog, but keep up with a young rambunctious dog. So her play style can be adjusted, and that's awesome. We do know that she does not prefer cats, so no cats for this little girl. And children should probably be at least 5 and up, just because when she gets running around, she is fast, and we would hate for her to knock over a young one. And safety is always first in our book, always, right? And that's why the fenced-in yard would be best for her and her young age, to be able to run around and get that exercise, which is crucial for a young dog to be able to run off and run off that steam, that get that exercise. If not, and I know I mentioned this so many times during different shows, if a dog has cooped up energy and is bored, a lot of times they will find ways to, right? She's saying, absolutely. They will find ways to eat up or use up that energy inside the home, which a lot of times you might not be too fond of. Chewing is one way. I know they like to use up energy, which we are all not too fond of, unless it's with a proper toy, right, Addie? So again, you want to find and have means for them to be exercised properly. Walking, now is our weather maybe breaking. Please get your dogs out there for walks. Take them for walks. As you can see, Addie has her harness on. Harnesses are a great way to help pulling dogs. She pulls right now. So obedience training, again, will be a great thing for this young girl. Right, honey? All right. We are going to send our beautiful girl off. And again, she's been with us for a while, since 2016, and we just can't understand why. She came with us, to us, under a year, and now she's just turned a year. So it's sad, I don't know why. So please come out and meet her. She is really very patiently waiting for her forever home to come in and take her away. All right. We'll be right back with our next adoptable pet. All right, this is Ali, and Ali, A-L-I, is a Jack Russell mix. And again, we can never say for sure what a breed of dog is, because we're usually just guessing most of the time to the best of our knowledge with our experience in dealing with breeds. But he pretty much looks like a Jack Russell to us. Pretty much the bright size and all. Ali is about 3 years old, and I don't know if you've watched the show months past, but he came to us with some history that we knew that he had been abused in his past, and we knew that when he came to Humane Haven that we were going to need to have a patient hand, that he might be with us for some time, and that, you know, right away he wouldn't be able to go on our adoption page, and that was fine with us. because when we make a commitment to a pet, our commitment is to make sure we are with them until they are adopted, whether it be for medical reasons or mental stability reasons. With for him, it's trust issues right now, because the humans had let him down in the past. So we have been working with this wonderful little boy, and he has been very lucky to be able to stay with one of our volunteers who has been working with him in a training regard, which is called desensitization. And with a little boy who is reactive, unfortunately reactive in a sense where he wants to snap, because that is the first and most common defense mechanism a frightened dog will use, is snapping. You want to desensitize them to, you know, things that they're reacting to, and unfortunately he reacts to anything that startles him. So we're trying to desensitize them to loud noises, fast motion. And one thing he was very afraid of, we noticed in the beginning, was men. And we knew from his past that that was where most of his abuse had come from. So we also have been trying to have a lot of men visit with our little man here, and he is doing great. So progress report for Ali is he is doing great, but he will need, we believe, a more quiet family. We don't believe that Ali will probably ever want to progress into a very, you know, very, very active, loud party type of right family. Like right now he's thinking, why are you talking so much? And why are the bright lights on me? And those cameras are scary. It's a very scary place right now. And he actually just came from adoption, so he's had a lot for one afternoon. So he is, or I should say, the ideal forever home for this little guy would probably be a quiet home. I would recommend that it not have small children running around the home, grabbing for toys, or just not understanding that they might need to be more gentle with Ali. More or older children, more mature, that would be able to understand maybe what he has gone through and why they might need to be gentle and not grab at him and be slower and, you know, understand. So that's really all he needs. He's not a bad boy. He's scared. And look at how small he is. He lives in such a large world that has let him down by abusing him, which is horrible. You know, I just don't understand why anybody or anyone would need to harm an 8-pound animal beyond my ever knowing. So he's doing great. Our progress report is good. Ali's coming along, and with all our loving, tender care, that's all he needs. And as long as that continues, he is going to turn out to be a very loving little dog. That's all he needs, is consistent love. It's all he needed from the beginning, and he would have never had to learn to trust again to the level of his having to learn to trust right now. It's just not right. Right, buddy? Right. I know. So this is Ali. Again, Jack Russell, 3 years old. He doesn't need a fenced-in yard, but always will need to be on leash. And again, probably not the little dog that's going to want to go shopping at PetSmart or taken with you. Might want to be taken with you for rides in the car, but not necessarily taken in with you to busy locations. He definitely wants to hang with you and have a companion all the time. But really active areas right now are not his thing. But right now are not his thing. Maybe he'll come into that. Who knows, right? Who knows? But he's getting there. All right. We hope that Ali's forever family is out there. Patience is a virtue for that forever family. But we have patients here at Humane Haven, and we know you're out there. So if you'd like to come out and meet him, please do. He's a wonderful little man. Okay, we will be right back with our next adoptable pet. Okay, this is Jake. And Jake is a little Yorkshire Terrier. And we're pretty sure of that just by his looks. And like I always say, we can never be 100% sure because the majority come into us stray, so we are just guessing to the best of our experience and with the help of our veterinarian as well. But as you can see, Jake definitely looks like a little Yorkie. He's a little bit older. He's about 8 years old. And we know that after some investigating that Jake has Cushing's disease. And if you have joined us on past shows, you know that it is a disease that is very manageable, so it's nothing you should shy away from if he looks like a very cute dog you'd like to meet. And what it is in a quick summary, if I could explain, and then you can look up on the website, on the web, check it out. But what it is when a tumor is found in an adrenal gland, and his tumor is benign, and what it does is the body will then create more cortisone than the body can handle. And when there's an excess amount of cortisone in the body, it'll make a pet feel really thirsty, as well as a human. It's the same disease between animal and human. But you could be very thirsty, you could feel very hungry. Until you get those cortisone levels evened out, you're not feeling very well. So once we determined that, we could just tell Jake was drinking a lot and wanting to eat all the time, that something was up. We took him to the doctor and started investigating. And that's really what you should do as a pet owner when your pet's not feeling well. You don't just, you know, assume it's a bad day or, you know, maybe a cold. Maybe you monitor for a day or so, but after that, if your pet's still not feeling better, you definitely need to get your dog or pet cat examined by your doctor. It's your responsibility to follow through and find out why your pet's not feeling well. So that's exactly what we did with Jake. And we found out it was Cushing's disease like we had thought just by the amount of water he wanted to drink. And the first step was to do a blood test to see where those cortisone levels were. And we did that. And once you find out where the cortisone levels are, then you start your medication. And then what was required of us was to repeat a blood test to see then where the blood or cortisone levels were. And actually, after one dosing, we got to where the right levels were, but Jake was still drinking a lot. So we actually thought it was more behavioral, and the blood test really showed that, you know, the cortisone levels were great. So then we actually had to do some behavioral training with Jake and teach him not to drink so much water, because this little guy was so used to walking by the bowl of water and drinking because he was so thirsty that it became a habit. So, and working with him and doing that, he's drinking less water already. So it takes time when you have a pet that becomes ill, but it's your responsibility as a pet owner to stick it out. You can't just, you know, say, okay, I'm done, this pet has an illness, and on with the new pet. That's not right. It's your responsibility to stick it out and follow through, find out what you need to do, and do it. So this little guy just needs to have medication once a month, and it's pretty inexpensive, under $30. And you know, I always say when a medication or something is needed, it's pretty simple. You really just need to put a dollar or two in a jar a day, and by the end of the month, you'll have plenty of money to afford that medication. And we all know we spend more on McDonald's probably per day than that. So we should never say no to needing money for our pets, meds, or health, right? All right. Well, Jake certainly is not enjoying his time here on the set, but he is patiently waiting for his forever home. He's been with us since last year. And I certainly hope it's not because he has Cushing's. It's certainly nothing to fret about. And his little whining here is just a Yorkie trait. He doesn't do it when he's able to run around free. He does not like being restrained right now. All right, we're gonna let Jake go off.
Welcome to the cat segment of For the Love of Animals. We're very happy to have you with us today. And we have some wonderful cats we want you to meet. And the very first one is here with Gail. Who is this, Gail?
This is Gretchen.
Okay, look at, isn't she a beauty?
She is. Right now she's purring.
Uh-huh.
She likes attention. Mm-hmm. She is 12 years old. She's a long-haired calico.
Oh, and she's a sweetheart.
She is indeed. She likes attention. She likes to sit in your lap.
Yes, yes. Now, when we first got her, she did come in from animal control. She was outside. She was a stray. And when we first got her, she wasn't eating very well. Well, we took her to the vet for her initial checkup and everything. And the vet said, well, there was a good reason she wasn't eating, because most of her teeth were either cracked or rotten. And so she was going to need a serious dental, big time, a lot of extractions. So we scheduled that, and she had 12 teeth extracted.
Oh, poor thing.
Yeah, and she went home with one of our volunteers to take care of her and make sure she got her pain-killing meds on time and everything. But when she got home, the funny thing happened. She had, our volunteer had put some food on the floor, some wet food, just in case she was, you know, hungry later that day or something. Well, when she spotted the food, she went running over to it and ate the whole bowl.
Okay, so lack of teeth is not a problem here.
She was so hungry, and that's all she cared about. Now, she is just wonderful, as you can see. She is Miss Sweetness herself, aren't you?
Huh. She is, and she does enjoy being brushed, which is essential when you have a long-haired cat.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. And then because, actually, her fur was really badly matted when we got her, so we took her to our groomer, and he bathed her twice and brushed her out, and then he called us and said, you better take her back, he said, and wait 2 weeks, and then bring her back. He said, I bathed her twice, but I didn't want to subject her to that a third time in one day. So he said, make an appointment for 2 weeks from now, and we'll do her again. So we did. And this is what came of it.
And
okay.
Her fur is nice and soft.
Yes.
And you can tell there's no more oil or
right.
grease.
Right, no grease. She was very greasy when we first got her in. And she just loves people. She loves to be petted. Look at her. Yeah. Look at her.
I can't believe she's not trying to escape.
No, she wants attention. That's what she wants the most.
You're so sweet. She does like to be scratched under her chin.
Oh, yes.
And she doesn't mind her belly.
Yeah,
and like
she
your
eats
belly
well
scratched.
Now. Once she had her teeth taken
removed.
Care of. Yep, yep. So they removed 12, and she's doing absolutely fine. Her gums have healed up, and everything is good. So this is Gretchen. She's available for adoption. If you're interested in any of the cats you're going to see today, we'd like you to call us at 630-378-4208. Press 2 for cats, and leave your name and phone number, and tell us that there's a particular cat you'd like to meet. Tell us who it is, and we'll make arrangements for you to come in and spend some time with that kitty. So, and Gretchen is wonderful. What more can I say?
I can't. I love
her.
I can't believe this.
Yeah, she's lovely, isn't she?
Yes.
Yes. All right. Well, thank you so much for bringing her in, Gail.
You're welcome.
Now we have a short-haired girl we'd like you to meet. Mm-hmm. Judy, who have you got here?
This is Gia. And Carol said she's a short-haired gray.
She's
very
beautiful.
Soft. Her fur feels like cotton. Oh. And she's approximately 10 months old. And she is living with two of her sisters, but I was unable to get the other ones here today. So she gets along with other cats perfectly well. She's even met a couple of my own personal cats. And, sniffy noses, no sign of aggression or anything.
Good.
She's a love bug. At night, she just wants to cuddle up and purr and roll around. She's very playful. And
does she sleep with you at night?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Does she sleep the whole night?
Oh, yes, she does, actually. She didn't when she was little, but she does now.
Okay, yeah, she's bigger now. How old is she?
10 months.
10 months,
yeah.
Okay.
And all she wants to do is actually, literally, be right next to me while I'm sleeping. She'll periodically at night wake me up because she'll put her little paw on my shoulder and tap a little bit. No, but she's very well behaved. She's one of those rare kittens when I was raising them when they were younger that doesn't do any damage. I mean, the only thing she did would, you know, get up on something and knock it over, but not intentional. It'd just be that she bumped it. Mm-hmm. So she is one of the best, well-behaved cats I've ever had the pleasure to take care of.
Wow.
And she's just a wonderful, sweet little girl.
Yeah, and she's lovely. Yeah. She is just beautiful, yeah. Aren't you? Gia, we've talked before. I've told you how beautiful you are, huh? Yes. She says, I don't know what's going on here.
Her main thing is she loves to lay on the cat tree by the window, watch birds, lay in the sun, and once she starts purring, it's hard for her to stop. She just loves to purr.
Aww. So,
I mean, she's a great kitty.
Yeah, she certainly is. Mm-hmm. Now, she has two sisters.
Correct.
And that was the litter, right?
Yes.
They were
yeah.
in one litter, and
well,
they
the,
were
the
picked
fourth,
up.
The, yeah, brother, yeah.
The boy
mm-hmm.
went home already.
Right.
But, mm-hmm. but, okay, so they were picked up outside as strays.
Correct, yeah. They were only about 5 weeks old when mm-hmm. They came to our shelter. And so they needed someone, a little bit of continual bottle feeding to transition them over to regular kitten food. So I had the room and the time, and I'm very happy I took them on because they're all of them wonderful kitties.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, and she is just so, so sweet. She's a real sweetheart, aren't you, Gia? Hi, hon. Hi.
Oh, this is I her hope first public appearance, so she's a little... uncertain.
Well, but she's not real
no,
nervous
no, no,
appearing.
Not at all.
No,
not at all.
No.
I think she would do very well in a home with other cats. She has not really met dogs, so I can't honestly say how her reaction would be. But if the introduction is done properly, I'm sure she would adjust very quickly. Mm-hmm. But she's a mellow little cat, has times of play and sleeping.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And she eats well.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay,
yeah.
No problem there.
No problem.
Good.
No litter problems or anything.
Great. Wonderful. Okay, and she is spayed, and all our cats at Humane Haven are microchipped. So she's also microchipped, and you will get a tag with her microchip number on it if you decide to adopt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's had all her vaccinations and
yep.
everything.
She's
so.
Up to date on everything.
She's ready to find her forever home.
Absolutely. Yes. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Well, thank you, Judy, for bringing her.
No
and
problem.
Thank you, pretty girl, for being here. You're such a sweetie. Yes, you are. Look at you. She's, yeah, in this big, strange studio, and she's just fine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's a wonderful cat. Okay. Well, if you're interested in meeting her, give us a call, 630-378-4208. Press 2 for cats. Leave your name and phone number and tell us you want to meet Giga. She does not live at PetSmart. We do need to bring her in. But we can do that on a Wednesday or Sunday. Our hours are from 5 to 7 on Wednesdays and on Sundays from 1 to 3. So if you can come in during those times and you want to meet Gia, just let us know.
Okay.
Thank you. Now we have two, well, almost adult, mm-hmm. right, boys we want you to meet. And Judy, let's start with you. Who have you got?
This is Lafayette.
Okay.
And as you can see, they're almost twins,
yes,
at being brothers,
mm-hmm.
and both of them are extremely affectionate, wonderful cats. As you notice, Lafayette has a harness,
mm-hmm.
and he loves to walk around. Even when we show him at PetSmart,
you might see him strolling down the aisles on his harness,
yeah.
though.
He loves to go around. He actually greets people when they come over to see the other cats at adoption,
mm-hmm.
and Lafayette also goes and sits around and greets the other cats, too.
Yeah.
They're just the most mellow, laid-back, calm, gentle boys.
Yes.
But they're also young, so they love to play. They can get into their friendly, frisky moods, too.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think I've personally ever seen two cats, especially Mr. Lafayette here, who is more affectionate and laid-back. They're very
yes.
mellow.
Now, this is Toulouse that I'm stroking here, and this is his brother, and he also... We can put a harness on him and he'll walk around. But Lafayette is the one that really
yeah.
loves to do it.
Yeah.
And so he's probably the one that'll greet more people. Yes, what?
That's your brother.
That's your brother. What are you gonna do? Huh? You wanna lay down by your brother? Is that it or what? He doesn't know.
Yeah.
No, he doesn't know. Oh, really? Oh, I'm sorry.
My.
We're just gonna keep you right here, okay? I know. They're very affectionate cats, too.
Mm-hmm.
They like people, right? Do you like people? Huh?
He's the talker, I understand.
Yes, yes.
Where this is, he, I don't know, Lafayette always reminds me of someone just studies and takes everything in and evaluates it. And he studies a lot of stuff. He's very alert.
Now, these boys, as you can see, are long-haired kitties, which means they're going to need some extra grooming time, probably every day. Brushing of some sort, right? Huh? Would you like to be brushed every day? I bet you would. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But anyway, so they are available. They're about 9 months old. Mm-hmm. They're already neutered. And they're microchipped, as all our cats are. Isn't that right? Huh? Yeah, I know. Yeah. And they're wondering what they're doing in this strange room with all these lights. No, it's okay.
You'll go home.
It's okay. You're fine. All right? Yeah, your brother's here and we're here. Nothing's going to happen to you. Yeah. So if you're interested in these guys, give us a call. Again, they do not live at PetSmart. But if you would like to meet them, we'd be very happy to show them to you. And we are there from 5 to 7 on Wednesdays and from 1 to 3 on Sundays. And we can have these guys there any of that time that you would like to come and meet them. Okay? Yes. You are the talker, aren't you? I didn't realize how much you talked. Oh, okay. Okay. You sound very sad right now. Did you and your brother want to go home? Is that it? Huh?
And Mr. Mellow is just being mellow.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway. Okay. So these are both very sweet, wonderful cats. Let us know if you're interested. Okay? Yes. All right. Thanks for being here, guys. Thanks, Judy.
You're welcome.
All right. Now we have another girl we want you to meet, and she's young, right, Kathy?
Yes.
Now, who is this, first of all?
This is Smokey.
Okay.
She's about 6 months old. Mm-hmm. She's already been microchipped up to date on shots, and right. She was just recently spayed.
Okay.
She's a little bit shyer than some of the other kittens.
Uh-huh.
Although she's very affectionate, it just takes her personality a little bit longer to come out.
Uh-huh. Did she come in by herself?
No, she came in with a little sister who was half her size. She came in with Squirt, Squirt's sister.
Oh, okay, and Squirt has gone home, so now this little girl is by herself.
Yeah, she's just waiting for her home. Mm-hmm. She doesn't get as much attention as her sister because her sister was really outgoing.
Right, right. This little girl's very quiet.
Yes.
I don't think I've ever heard her meow.
No, she's quiet. She's reserved. Mm-hmm. She does love to be petted. But, you know, again, she's shy, so it takes her a little bit to come out.
Okay.
But anyone who would give her a chance to get to know her won't be unhappy with her because she's very sweet, she's playful.
Good.
And she gets along with the other cats.
Okay. Now, what about kids? Because she's shy.
Was okay with my grandson, but my grandson has been raised with a cat, and he's very respectful.
Okay.
I think respectful kids.
Okay.
I wouldn't want a four-year-old to be carrying her around because that wouldn't be good for her.
Right. But older kids would be okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She doesn't, you know, she's shy. She doesn't have anything aggressive about her.
Does she hide?
Sometimes.
Okay. Depending on what's going on, right?
Correct.
Yeah.
She doesn't like going to PetSmart.
Okay.
She doesn't like the vet.
Yeah, well, you've shown me a cat that likes the vet. I mean, really? But, nothing personal, vets, but that's the way it is.
In the areas that she's comfortable in, she's out all the time.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, she's a beautiful girl.
Doesn't she? She's got a beautiful face.
Yes. Yes. And being shy, there's nothing wrong with that.
No.
You know?
And she's got lovely whiskers, don't you?
Oh, yes. Yes. So you think she'd be okay with other cats?
Oh, she's fine with the other cats. In fact, she's one of them, and maybe because she's not very forward, the other kittens gravitate towards her.
Really?
Because she's calm.
Okay, sure. Sure, that makes sense. So everybody likes her.
Yeah, so she seems to make them a little secure when someone new comes in.
Okay, all right. Well, that's wonderful. Wow. Oh, you're going to miss her when she gets adopted, aren't you?
Yes,
yeah, because Kathy's been taking care of her since we got her in. Now, how old was she when you first got her? She was little.
Yeah, I think only about 8 weeks.
Oh, wow.
Because her sister got adopted very quick.
Yes.
But a lot of times, people either love the black cats or they don't like them, so it's not unusual for us to have a black cat longer than another cat.
Sure.
And with her being shy, it doesn't help because a lot of people come in and they want to meet a cat who's going to be more like Gretchen,
right?
Which
right.
is You're unusual,
outgoing. Yeah.
Because cats generally take a little more time to warm up,
right?
Anyway,
yeah, yeah. Okay. Well, everybody, this is Smokey.
You're okay.
You know, she's already spayed. She's microchipped. She has all her shots. Everything's up to date. She's healthy, and she's looking for her forever home. So if you can give her that home, please call us, 630-378-4208, press 2 for cats, and leave your name and number, and we will arrange for you to meet this lovely little girl. Thank you, sweetie, for being here today. Isn't this little girl beautiful? I think she is, and I know Kathy thinks she is, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Can you tell us about her? Who is she?
This is Charlie. What, she's about 9 months old?
Mm-hmm.
She came from a house that was hoarding cats, mm-hmm. and they all had medical issues. When we got Charlie, she couldn't see at all. Her right eye, she's blind in, and her left eye was covered by her third eyelid, which the eye doctor recommended we remove so she could have vision in her left eye.
Mm-hmm.
And it was amazing to watch how she's grown and changed since she can see.
Yeah, now tell us what happened when she, you took her to have that third eyelid removed. Okay, Dr. Lehal did that, our vet. And you brought her home, and then what went on? Was it the next day, or was it the same day that little occurrence happened?
Oh, she was just, had to touch everything. Because before then, she couldn't see, and she had a respiratory infection, so she couldn't smell. She would actually roll around the floor and bump into her food in the litter box. And when she came home, when that eye was uncovered, it was like she just couldn't stop. She had to touch everything. Anything that she could reach, she had to touch.
Wow.
And she was just so amazing to watch.
I bet it was.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. Oh. You know, I think hoarders, they probably have an idea that they want to do something good, and there are stray cats, and we'll take them in and keep them warm and that kind of thing, but they don't realize that they're going to need medical care, and most people who bring a whole lot of cats in don't have the wherewithal to take care of them.
True. Okay. It would take a lot of money to keep up that group of kittens, and once you get somebody in there who's got upper respiratory infections or different infections that they pass on to the other ones.
And it gets expensive.
Yes.
It really does.
So it's really hard to keep up with, and then you have that spreading.
Right.
She's very playful. The only difference that I notice, she doesn't seem to care for the real young kittens.
Mm.
I think they move too fast for her. So anything really fast moving will kind of startle her. But she is in the room with the other cats.
Mm-hmm. And she looks gray to me, but she isn't.
No, she's actually a tortie.
Uh-huh. She has different colors in different places on her body. And she's just beautiful. Huh. You're just beautiful. Now, where does she sleep at night? Do you know?
She sleeps in a cuddler. She'll sleep next to Smokey sometimes.
Will she?
And sometimes she'll sleep alone.
Okay. All right. So she doesn't mind the other cats?
No, and she's very playful. She loves her toys.
Oh, wonderful. Wonderful.
And she even washes them. She likes to drop her toys in the water dish. I don't know why.
Does she pick them out herself then, or no? She just leaves
them?
Oh, really?
Other times she just leaves them. We've got a lot of wet mice.
Oh, I bet. I bet. You drown those little mousies, huh? Do you do that? She's really a small cat, isn't she?
Yeah, she's a petite little girl.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, sweetie, we're so glad you came today, Charlie. Yeah, she's a girl named Charlie. Remember that. Come and meet her. I think anybody who meets her has got to like her.
Yes.
You know?
Really.
She's such a sweet baby.
Yes. She actually is a very affectionate cat.
Yeah. That's wonderful. Well, thank you so much for bringing her today. Now we'd like you to meet two kittens, and they are a brother and sister. Let's start with Gail. Gail, who do you have?
I have Arietta. She's 4 months old.
Okay.
She's all black except for her paws are
white. And she's got
a little bit of white tummy and chest.
Yes.
And under her neck.
Mm-hmm.
She's kind of shy.
She loves
to be held.
For anybody who likes,
if you want to hold a kitty, she's the girl, right?
She likes to be held.
Now, she is from a litter of four, and I have her brother right here. His name is Fowler, and he is a handsome all-black boy. And These are the two that have not been adopted yet. They're the first, the other two who were both boys have gone home already. And so we're now looking for forever homes for these two. It's okay, baby. You're all right.
And they are adorable. I, you know what?
They're just beautiful.
Black cats have the best temperament. I love black cats.
I know. And they're very sweet. And these two love, they curl up together at night. And they play with toys, don't you? You like toys?
Look at.
Yeah, there's your brother. Yeah. Remember him? We took them out of the carrier separately, and I'm not sure she knew where he went. Yeah. But they do hang around together.
And they've had a busy day.
They have.
They've been at PetSmart today for a couple of hours.
Yes.
Huh. For visiting.
Yes. And they are doing really, really well. Yes. Now, they're not 6 months old yet, but generally spays and neuters occur about the time they're 6 months old. Oh, no, don't worry. We're not going to do anything to you today. But but anyway, so another month or so, and they need to be scheduled for their spay and their neuter, okay?
They have been microchipped, right?
Yes, they are microchipped. They've had a blood draw to make sure that they're healthy, and they are. You're both very healthy.
And have you had all your vaccinations?
And they have. Mm-hmm. And they've had their rabies shot already. Everything is done, okay, except the spay and neuter. That's the only thing. But they're too young yet for that. So anyway, that's to come in the future. But if you would like to meet these beautiful kitties, please call us, 630-378-4208, and leave your name and phone number, and someone will call you back. And if you need more information, whatever that might be, Judy does most of the callbacks, and she will call you back and try to answer all your questions about them. Isn't that right?
Yeah.
Huh. Yeah. They're just such beautiful kittens.
Yes,
aren't they?
They are.
Sweet. And she's got white whiskers, too.
White.
Did you notice?
Yes, she does.
She has white whiskers.
They're very calm.
Yes,
cats.
They are. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And they're not very vocal, either. So if you're thinking about, you know, you want to get a cat, but you don't want it screaming at you all the time.
They're quiet kitties.
They're quiet, aren't you? Yeah. Oh, you're so sweet. Okay. Well, this is Fowler.
And
that
Arietta.
Is Arietta. Okay. Thank you, Gail.
You're welcome.
Well, now we have another pair of kittens, a brother and a sister. They don't look anything alike, though, do they?
No, they don't.
Okay.
They got different daddies.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. And people say, you know, well, how can those kittens be from the same litter? They don't look alike. But that's the reason. They have different daddies. You know, same mom. But anyway, but this little handsome dude, hello, who is this?
This is Oliver.
Okay. He is gorgeous.
He is beautiful.
Look,
he's got the best markings.
Yes. And that's called a classic tabby. Because it's not the usual tabby stripes that you see. And I don't think there are as many classic tabbies as regular tabbies. Do you agree?
Yeah, I don't see as many anyway.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so this is him. Now, who's that?
That is Annie.
Okay, and, they are brother and sister, right?
Yes.
Same litter. Different, I would say mom, but different daddies. Look at that. Now, how old do we think they are? They were born September 20th. October, November, December, January. So they're about 4 months.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So they're too young to be spayed and neutered yet?
Correct.
Yes. But they have all their shots?
Yes, they do.
Okay. And they're microchipped?
Yes.
And they're really ready to go home. What kind of personalities do they have, though, Kathy? Now, these two live with you.
Yes, they're very confident. Even when they go to PetSmart, they reach out to greet everybody and touch everybody. They enjoy being touched.
Mm-hmm.
They're not very happy right now. I can hear Annie over here making all kinds of unhappy noises. But they're very playful. And I tell people, unless you have a good sense of humor, you don't want Oliver because he is into everything.
Is he?
Yes.
Like, what do you mean by everything?
Oh. He likes to take the remote control for the TV.
Oh. Does he hide it?
He just takes it.
Okay.
He changed the language on my TV, and I needed help getting back to a language I understood. Just pushing the buttons, moving it around. He moves the litter box around.
Really?
Don't know why.
Oh, why do you do that? Huh? You haven't told Kathy why you do that. Is there a reason? Oh, no.
He just likes to remain active.
I guess so.
And Annie is the only girl in the room, so she's the little boss.
Is she?
Yeah, she likes to keep control over everybody.
Wow. Okay. Well, and she's littler, too.
She
quite
is
a bit
a lot smaller. I'm not sure if Oliver is just going to be big and she's going to be very small.
Petite little girl.
Yes, she is.
Yeah. Wow. What are you growling about, mister? Huh? He says, I don't know. I've never been here before. What am I supposed to do?
My sister is growling, so I have to.
Yeah, right. I'm going to follow what she does. Wow. Well, these are more beautiful kittens that we have. And, you know, this isn't kitten season yet because this is the end of, well, yeah, the beginning of February. We won't be seeing kittens, haha. We hope, anyway, we won't be seeing kittens for a while. Newborns, I mean. But anyway, but these guys are available. So give us a call. They're not going to last forever, and they're going to grow up. If you're looking for a young cat, now is the time to get them, right?
Yes.
Absolutely. Okay. All right. All right, Oliver. It's okay.
What?
Thanks, guys.
All
guys.
Right. You're
thanks,
okay.
Ladies. Now we have two more kitties to show you. Two more kittens. And believe it or not, they're black. It seems like we've had a run of black kitties, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, but now, Kathy, who do you have here?
This is Velvet.
Okay, now tell us about Velvet.
Velvet is a black kitty with some white markings on him. Uh-huh. His mother was an outdoor cat who he watched get run over by a car.
Oh, my heavens.
And a man who was feeding them was able to get two of the kittens right away and brought them into the vet's office. And Velvet here crawled into the engine of a van. Which
oh,
one of our
dear.
Volunteers and some people who worked in the area decided that they were going to disassemble
rescue?
The van to
did they?
Get Velvet
to
out.
To get him out.
Yeah, I think they took the whole dashboard out.
Oh, my goodness.
But they weren't leaving without him.
Oh, my. Oh, you are such a fortunate kitty. You have no idea what could have happened to you, huh? Oh, and he's got white whiskers, too, just like another kitty we had.
He's got really pretty white whiskers, although one of his buddies are chewing them off.
Oh,
so they're not short right now.
Yeah.
They're short right now.
Yeah. Cats do that if they feel like they chew each other's whiskers. Yeah.
See, I didn't understand
that before.
Huh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But anyway, so, okay, so he came from inside the engine of a car. Oh, my goodness. Boy, are we lucky to have him. Yeah. Now, okay, who is this over here then?
That is Kringle.
Okay. Now, is he related to this one?
No.
Okay, separate black kitty, another black kitty. Okay. All right. So, Kringle is what? I'm guessing close to 4 months?
Yes.
He looks like he's going to be a little bigger. His ears are bigger than this guy's.
Yes.
Okay, so he's maybe, yeah, if he's not quite 4 months old, he's got a lot of growing to do yet, a lot of time to grow, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so, Kringle, I'm guessing, we got him in December?
Yes. Good guess.
That's why his name is Kringle. Okay, and what do we know about him? Where did he come from?
I believe he was just picked up from animal control as
a stray,
if I'm not mistaken.
Wow.
He, like Velvet, is a little more shy, mm-hmm. But they're both very loving, very playful, and I don't know what... Kringle's tail got into, but when he holds his tail up, mm-hmm. it looks like a question mark.
Oh,
he's
really?
Got about an inch on the end that is bent over. Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
And until he holds his tail up, you can't see it, but it's kind of funny.
Right? Oh.
He said, I'm not going to hold my tail up.
Yeah. Why my tail is hidden.
That's right.
Yeah, that's okay. That's okay. He's beautiful too.
Yeah, and
all
he has beautiful eyes.
Are gorgeous. Yeah. And is he playful?
Very playful.
Okay. All right. Gets into a lot of mischief?
No, not as much as, no one gets into as much trouble as Oliver does. They're
Oliver
all playful.
Has a reputation.
Yes, he does.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
And he loves treats. He's very treat motivated.
Oh, Kringle is?
Yes.
Oh, very nice. Very nice.
And he's not shy to the point where he hides, because sometimes when the cats are very shy, they'll try hiding. Kringle doesn't hide.
Oh, okay.
And he, like I said, he's always ready for a treat.
Right.
It just takes him a little bit more.
Sure. And that's okay. That's certainly okay. And this guy's got the white paws, right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Well, if you haven't seen a kitty here today that you like, keep looking. come into PetSmart and see what we have there. We bring the kittens in on Wednesdays and Sundays. Wednesday evening between 5 and 7, Sundays between 1 and 3. And come and talk to us. If you don't see a kitty there that you're really interested in, maybe we know of another kitty that just came in and isn't ready yet to come into PetSmart or something. But anyway, if you see anybody here, please come and see us. Please come and meet them. They all need homes. And we hope we'll hear from you soon. Thank you, ladies, for being with us. Mm-hmm. And we'll see you next month on For the Love of Animals.
Don't forget, if you lose your pet, to contact your local authorities immediately. They can help your pet find its way safely home. And remember, a pet is not a toy. It's a lifelong commitment. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next show. Bye-bye.
Bye.